Yo, 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 what is up, Diamond family? It's your man Vivi, and welcome back to the VVS Academy. As you guys know, I'm here every week dropping off gems, teaching you to record and mix your music better. So if that sounds good to you, stick around, man. Look, I got a really crazy video for you guys today. We're showing you guys the secret to EQing hip-hop vocals. A lot of times they can get kind of thin and harsh and really sound super unprofessional, especially when you're recording at home. I'm gonna show you guys how to fix that right now. All right, I'm not even gonna overtalk it, but look, if you're still struggling to get your vocals to sit inside of the beat and balance themselves out perfectly every single time, check out my free course down below. It's going to completely change the game for you, man. It's going to teach you my simple technique for balancing out the vocals and the beat perfectly every single time. The whole course takes about 15 minutes. It's completely free, so check it out down below. All right, let's jump into this track. We'll play it back and see where we at.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always consider you, what about how I feel? Apple of my eye, and I still had to keep my eyes peeled. Nah.
Cool, so as you can hear, he's spitting, the vocal sounds good, it sounds clean. How do we achieve this, right? Well, first, let's fix some problems. The first thing I notice is I think the beat is a little bit quieter than it needs to be. So let's start over. I'm gonna get rid of this trimmer. I'm actually just gonna use the VMR. Let's bypass the effects that we have here, and we're only gonna focus on adjusting the volume. So let's go.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with.
I mean, we might be there. We might not need to do anything else. We might have just not needed to turn it down at all. Let me listen again.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always can.
Cool. I like that a lot. I love the way that the echoes are kind of slapping back at you. It really gives you that lo-fi kind of hip-hoppy sound. So I really like what we did there with the effects. Let's go ahead and dive into the vocal to make sure that they are where they should be volume-wise.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit.
Yeah, we're good money. All right, bet. So how do we now take these vocals that could become thin and harsh and very hollow and not really present themselves well and turn them into those solid vocals that you connect with and that you really want to hear? Let's start with the VMR. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is try to get some saturation, some kind of analog feel, because hip-hop vocals, they have a lot of saturation. They're very lo-fi more often than not. They're not nearly as clean and hi-fi as, like, you know, a trap vocal or a regular rap vocal. Like, these should sound a little underground, like you recorded them in a basement, that kind of vibe. So I'm not gonna really stress things getting too bright, right? So what I'm gonna do is first grab a compressor, actually, and I'm gonna use the Black 1176 because this is gonna accentuate the low end of the vocal and keep it from getting too thin. All right, so the first thing you can do is grab a compressor that's gonna support you trying to keep low end in your vocal and not make it too mid forward. So let's dial some in.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always consider you, what about how I feel? Apple of my eye, and I still had to keep my eyes peeled. Nah, really hope you see the fruits of my labor now, but guess you'll have to hear the truth of my anger out, cause my heart's breaking again.
Cool, I like the way that sounds. All right, I'm about to show you guys a super secret engineering trick, and it's called the API EQ trick. I use this a lot, and we're gonna see if it works here. A lot of tricks that we kind of use and know, it's just trial and error. You see, like, yo, will this work on this vocal? And if it does, like, nope. If it doesn't, you gotta try something else. So what the trick is, you take the top band of the API EQ, you move it all the way to 20, and you roll that back. And now let's see if it kind of thickens up the vocal.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with.
Now let's go the opposite way, take it away.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with.
And so what you notice is that it gets a little less spitty. It's like he's not spitting out the words like he was before. It's a little more smooth, a little more controlled, and it sounds more effortless, his verse does. So let me overdo it, you know, exaggerate it so you can really hear what's happening and back it up.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with.
And so that's starting to push up a little bit too much of the upper mid, and that's because of the way the curve is shaped. So let's go ahead and pull our way back. Let's go half of that at 6.
Y'all feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You trying to pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always consider you, what about how I feel? Apple of my eye, and I still had to keep my eyes peeled. Now
I like that. And so from here, what you want to try to avoid is any tool that's going to add too much upper mid range. So I like to use Fresh Air a lot. I wouldn't use that on a vocal like this. I like to use the Arvox a lot. I wouldn't use that on a vocal like this, because again, what we want to do is accentuate that body and presence that's already there in his vocal while kind of minimizing the high-end nasally kind of spitty aspects of his vocal. So the next thing that you want to make sure that you dial in is some de-essing. A lot of times vocals like these can really get away from you with the S's, because again, they're very lo-fi. They're very, you know, saturated. And so you want to make sure that you keep a good control over these things. And if we control these S's well, it's going to keep the vocal from getting too thin. So watch this.
Y'all, feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. You tryna pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always consider you, what about how I feel? Apple of my eye, and I still had to keep my eyes peeled. Nah, really hope you see the fruits of my labor now.
Ooh, I like that. So the last thing I would do to really round out this vocal and really give it that fatness in that body is tape. I like to use the tape machine to saturate, and specifically, I like to use the virtual tape machine from Slate. So, I can't spell, but if I could, there we go. We'll grab the virtual tape machine. And one thing that I like about this is that you can choose the bias. So a lot of times for my vocals, I'll choose the low bias. And this FG9, I think, just adds more sub energy than the 45. But we'll flip through a few different settings and see what sounds best for this specific vocal.
Y'all, feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. Yeah. You tryna pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always consider you, what about how I feel? Apple of my eye, and I still had to keep my eyes peeled. Nah, really hope you see the fruits.
I prefer the 15 over the 30 for sure. The 30 was adding some low mid-range that was like pushing out a little bit more, but the 15 like completely eliminated it. And this is just the speed that the reels on the tape machine move. So this is going 15 ips or inches per second, where 30 ips was a little bit faster. I think it allows more transients through when it moves faster, but I like it better at 15.
Y'all, feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. Yeah. You tryna pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always consider you, what about how I feel? Apple of my eye, and I still had to keep my eyes peeled. Nah, really hope you see the fruits of my labor now. But guess you'll have to hear the truth of my anger out. Cause my heart's breaking again.
Cool, so I'm gonna give you guys one extra bonus tip that I think is really gonna help you out. So when you're working with a vocal like this that you're not trying to use a lot of the high end to kind of force presence, you really need to use some sidechain compression. I'm gonna show you guys how to dial that in right now. So you can use the music bus like I'm using, or you can add this directly to your beat channel. So I usually show it on the music bus. I'll show it on the beat channel this time. You wanna grab the stock compressor that comes with Pro Tools, almost said Logic, that comes built into Pro Tools. And we're gonna grab our parallel compression bus. We wanna make sure that we're sending, the key input, basically what tells this sidechain compression when to activate. We want our parallel compression channel to tell us that. All right, so let's dial in some settings that I like to use. And we'll go from there.
Y'all, feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. Yeah. You tryna pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always consider you, what about how I feel? Apple of my eye, and I still had to keep my eyes peeled. Nah, really hope you see the fruits of my labor now. But guess you'll have to hear the truth of my anger out. Cause my heart's breaking again.
Swear to God, we just got started, are we facing the end?
And as you can hear, the vocal gets a lot more present and a lot more clear, just because what we're doing is cutting the beat, ducking the beat, basically. We're turning the beat down just a little bit whenever the vocal crosses the threshold that we've set, which means that our vocal always stays legible. We can always hear what's said. It always stays just in front of everything, just in the, you know, in your face enough to keep the song sounding industry quality. And these are the secrets, man. These are the tips that I'm giving you guys week in and week out. And if you need a little bit more help, drop me a line down below. My name is Vivi, and I'm here for you. Remember, stay humble, make diamonds only. Peace.
Y'all, feel this, cause it ain't nothing but some real shit. Yeah. You tryna pull my card, but this ain't something I'ma deal with. I always consider you, what about how I feel? Apple of my eye, and I still had to keep my eyes peeled. Nah, really hope you see the fruits of my labor now. But guess you'll have to hear the truth of my anger out.